गोपी जना वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरा वनचारी यमुना तीरा वनचारी यमुना तीरा वनचारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय श्री गोपाल श्री गोपाल जय श्री गोपाल जय गौरनिताय 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 जय गौरनिताय जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय प्रभुपाद जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रीमद डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय इस्कॉन फाउंडर आचार्य बीबीटी फाउंडर आचार्य श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रीमद इस डिवाइन ग्रेस भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। ग्रंथराज श्रीमद् भागवतम की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंदी। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। We are continuing our reading from Srimad Bhagavatam. This is Canto 1, Chapter 1, Questions by the Sages, Text Number 19. Vayam tu na vitripyama uttama shloka vikrame यच्चिण्वतां रसज्ञानां स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे। वयं तु न वितृप्याम उत्तमश्लोकविक्रमे यच्चिण्वतां रसज्ञानां स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे। वयं तु न वितृप्याम उत्तमश्लोकविक्रमे यच्चिण्वतां रसज्ञानां स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे। वयं तु न वितृप्याम उत्तमश्लोकविक्रमे यच्चिण्वतां रसज्ञानां स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे। Word to word meaning, Vayam, we. टू बट न नॉट वितृप्यामः शैल बी एट रेस्ट उत्तम श्लोक द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड हु इज ग्लोरिफाइड बाय ट्रांसेंडेंटल प्रेयर्स विक्रमे एडवेंचर्स यत विच शृण्वताम बाय कंटिन्यूअस हियरिंग रस ह्यूमर ज्ञानम दोज हु आर कन्वर्सेंट विथ स्वादु रिलिशिंग स्वादु पैलेटेबल पदे पदे एट एवरी स्टेप ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय Translation. We never tire of hearing the transcendental pastimes of the personality of Godhead, who is glorified by hymns and prayers. Those who have developed a taste for transcendental relationship with Him relish hearing of His pastimes at every moment. Purport. There is a great difference between mundane stories, fiction or history and the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. The histories of the whole universe contain references to the pastimes of the incarnations of the Lord. The Ramayana, the Mahabharata and the Puranas are histories of bygone ages recorded in connection with the pastimes of the incarnation of the Lord and therefore remain fresh even after repeated readings. For example, anyone may read Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam repeatedly throughout his whole life and yet find in them new light of information. Mundane news is static, whereas transcendental news is dynamic, in as much as the spirit is dynamic and matter is static. Those who have developed a taste for understanding the transcendental subject matter are never tired of hearing such narrations. One is quickly satiated by mundane activities, but no one is satiated by transcendental or devotional activities. Uttama Shloka indicates that literature which is not meant for nations. Mundane literature is in the mode of darkness or ignorance, whereas transcendental literature is quite different. Transcendental literature is above the mode of darkness and its light becomes more luminous with progressive reading and realization of transcendental subject matter. The so-called liberated persons are never satisfied by the repetition of the words Aham Brahmasmi. Such artificial realization of Brahman becomes hackneyed, and so to relish real pleasure they turn to the narrations of Srimad Bhagavatam. Those who are not so fortunate turn to altruism and worldly philanthropy. This means the Mayavad philosophy is mundane, whereas the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam is transcendental. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam साद्वैतम सावधूतम परिजना सहितम कृष्ण चैतन्य देवम श्री राधा कृष्ण पदान सहगणा ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामीन इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिने गौरत्विषे नमः हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार शिवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा। So welcome all the devotees for today morning Sunday Srimad Bhagavatam class. We are discussing the first chapter of the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And these are very beautiful verses. Today's verse is very, very nectarian verse. Swadu, swadu, pade, pade. Right? The verse itself is tasty and relishable. And full of rasa, rasa jnanam. So this verse speaks about how the rishis, the sages of Naimisharanya, are pleading to Suta Goswami, please keep narrating because we are relishing and we don't want to stop. And this is something which very difficult, right? At 10 o'clock, you will all be seeing at the watch when the Bhagavatam is going to end and the next swad of Kichdi or whatever it is made today, Prasad will come. So, sometimes such glimpses may come in our life also where we don't want the Bhagavatam class to stop. But very rarely, most of the time we know that Bhagavatam class is for 1 hour, so manageable, I can go. For me also, if you say, Prabhu, you can speak Bhagavatam as much as you want, after some time, I also will get dry. I'll have to go and drink water, take some prasad, maybe make someone else sit here. So this is something which is like an aspiration of every devotee, to taste Srimad Bhagavatam at every step. Swadu, swadu, pade, pade. Srimad Bhagavatam is indeed nectar. Everything about Krishna is nectar. Srila Prabhupada says that why we can taste every step, because this Krishna consciousness, anything about Krishna is very dynamic. And anything about matter is very static. Like one time Srila Prabhupada was in New York and the reporter of New York Times was called upon and there was an interview to be conducted with Srila Prabhupada. So when the reporter entered Srila Prabhupada's room, immediately Prabhupada picked up, immediately Prabhupada asked her a question. Generally, reporter asks question to the person whose interview is taken. Prabhupada sometimes did something else also. Prabhupada asked her a question. See, you are printing, we are also printing, right? You print newspapers, we print books. The same pages are there, like we buy from the same maybe market or same stores. And we are also using the ink. So most everything what you are doing, we are also doing, right? It's almost same, printing business. Why is it that whatever you print, the newspaper, the next day no one reads, they throw it away. But whatever we print, people keep and keep reading regularly. Any reason? So the reporter could not reply. It was a very nice question that, you know, both are printing, the same resources are used, but why one thing is kept temporarily, other thing is kept for a long time? And Srila Prabhupada mentioned to her that whatever you print is all about this mundane material world. So therefore, after some time, it becomes stale, basi. But whatever is printed about Krishna, it remains ever fresh. Ruchiram navam navam. So therefore, anything, the same printing, the same page, the same ink, but you speak or glorify Krishna through it, then that becomes a very prominent or permanent thing. People read it again and again. People keep reciting and hearing and discussing about it. So Srila Prabhupada says that this mundane, anything mundane doesn't remain for a long time. In the Nectar of Devotion, Srila Prabhupada said, there is rasa in the material world as well. There is rasa. That's why people are moving around and so many things are happening. Because there is some rasa, kuch ras mil raha hai. However, that rasa is very, very limited. Prabhupada says in the introduction of Nectar of Devotion, it's like chapala sukha. Chapala sukha means flickering happiness. One devotee was mentioning, chapala sukha also may speak in Hindi, chapala is something chapal, right? Sukh ke saath chapal hi milti hai. You get a lot of pains with that sukha. Chapala sukha. And bhoga tyaga. Anything in this material world we take up with a lot of excitement, after some time the excitement is gone. The same thing which you want to take becomes very displeasurable, right? If someone tells you, let's go to Chopati Beach, you say, wow, Chopati Beach. I'll take so many selfies and upload on my Instagram, on my Facebook page. And the next day the friend comes, let's go to Chopati Beach. So, theek hai, chalo. The excitement becomes less. After some time, third day, let's go to Chopati Beach. The excitement is lesser. And finally you get bored, what Chopati Beach? Kahin aur jayenge na yaar. Let's go to a new place. Why? Because the same place doesn't attract us. The same thing does not attract because it's mundane. Prabhupada said Krishna consciousness is not like that. It is ever increasing. And therefore, those devotees who have entered deep into Krishna consciousness can relish it every moment. Like this is not some flattery which Shonakadi Rishis are saying, Swadhu, Swadhu, Pade, Pade, Bol Diya. No. Because like for example, if someone says Swadhu, Swadhu, Pade, Pade, and the opposite person takes it seriously and starts speaking Bhagavatam for hours together, you will be in trouble, you know. Kyun bola yaar? So they are really serious about it. Swadhu, Swadhu, Pade, Pade. We are relishing. We are not na trippyama, na vitrippyama. Not satisfied, not satiated. So this is something which is like a very, very unique thing. Which comes at the advanced stage of Krishna consciousness. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life we see, he was always swadhu, swadhu, pare, pare. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling from Bengal to Jagannath Puri. And he was traveling via Kolkata. So he came to this place called as Baranagar. Or Baranagar, Baranagar, different ways you can pronounce. And there while traveling on one hut, there was one devotee who did not know, who never had seen Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not knew about him actually physically in one sense. Raghunath Upadhyay. And he was reciting Srimad Bhagavatam. For whom? No one. Himself. Trying to please Krishna. In his heart, every day recite Bhagavatam. But he recited Bhagavatam so beautifully, it was very enchanting and attractive. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going by the same road. He heard that beautiful sound vibration, recitation of Srimad Bhagavatam. He entered into the hut and sat down and started hearing the Bhagavatam. And he said, don't stop, keep reciting. And he kept reciting. Raghunath Upadhyay kept reciting the Bhagavatam And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard the Bhagavatam and fainted in ecstasy hearing the Bhagavatam. Then danced while Bhagavatam class is going on, he was dancing. Right? No one will dance in Bhagavatam class. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was relishing swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade. And he said, very nice. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that your name is Raghunath Upadhyaya. Whatever your name may be, there, I'll give you a new name. Bhagavat Acharya. So today also in Calcutta, there is a beautiful temple, Patbari, where this place is there. This temple where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met this devotee, Bhagavat Acharya. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's relishing. He was walking on the road and suddenly Bhagavatam attracts him and sits there for long hours and keeps hearing Bhagavatam from Bhagavat Acharya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed the same relish in many places. In Jagannath Puri also, you see, you would often go to Tota Gopinath to hear Bhagavatam from Gadadhar Pandit. And how many times? Unlimited times. It is said that he would ask Gadadhar Pandit to speak about Prahlad Maharaj's pastime again and again and again. 17 times, 18 times. The same story, again and again. Swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade. He was relishing it. Now, as we see that swadhu, swadhu, this word, it means palatable, tasteful, and relishing. And rasa jnanam, that means full of rasa. There is a lot of rasa in Bhagavatam. There is a lot of rasa in all the literatures of Krishna consciousness. And therefore, those who have reached that stage, they can experience the rasa. Swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade. Those who haven't reached that stage, they are still figuring that out. How it's swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade. It's swadhu, but why two times swadhu, swadhu, you know? How can it be pade, pade, you know, every step? I relish Bhagavatam on Sunday morning from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Swadhu is there, definitely some nice swadhu is there. If I'm coming for Srimad Bhagavatam. But how can it be swadhu, swadhu, and pade, pade, every step? There has to be some reason for that. So, such kinds of verses are there in all literatures of our Krishna consciousness. Bhagavatam is full of such verses, where there is a glorification about the holy name, glorification of Lord's pastime. Lord is called as Uttama Shloka, one who is glorified by best of choices shlokas. Right? And then such pastimes are Ruchiram, Navam Navam, and Na Tripyama, Syat Rati Kvachit. Nanyatra syad rati kochit. Such taste you will not find any place but this. So while I was reading this verse, I was thinking that maybe I should explore now how to get that taste. That's very important. It's very good to glorify someone else's taste, but also what about us, you know? So I was reading a very beautiful article by Gaurang Darshan Prabhu. He mentioned how to develop taste in hearing. So we compiled the whole formula from the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. So he said very beautifully in his compilation, we should learn from the sages of Naimisharanya how to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. If we know how to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, then we'll develop taste for Srimad Bhagavatam. So the first thing is, as we see in the Bhagavatam pages, when Suta Goswami came, Shaunaka Adi Rishi, they welcomed him, they honored him, and they offered him a seat. They praised his purity, and they praised his great qualities. So the person whom we are relishing or we're getting the taste of Srimad Bhagavatam, that person has to be honored. Like for example, Srila Prabhupada gave us Bhagavatam. We did not even know what Bhagavatam is all about, but we got Bhagavatam. And Prabhupada so intelligently installed Bhagavatam class in the daily morning program, right? Which means Bhagavatam was actually literally given. Take it. Srila Prabhupada is the one acharya whom we should actually honor and respect. That without him, there was no chance of us connecting to Bhagavatam, right? And hearing Bhagavatam class. So respect has to be given to the person who is giving us Bhagavatam. Then second step is, we should express to the speaker our eagerness to hear. Great enthusiasm in hearing Bhagavatam. That's very important. Like if the Bhagavatam class is going on and if the audience is not very attentive, what will happen? The speaker also will feel, let's end the Bhagavatam class early, right? But if the audience is attentive and the speaker is also enthusiastic, what will happen? The Bhagavatam continues with a very smooth flow. So very important, the express, physically sitting is there and then expressing that we want to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. I mentioned in the last half of my class that, you know, Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj is mentioning a beautiful point that generally in Bhagavatam, if there's a nice story going on, people are very attractive, people are very attentive in hearing the story, right? As soon as philosophy comes, suddenly people change asanas, right? People go in different special yogasanas. She was mentioning that when story is going on, then people are in a very alert position, right? They are in Padmasana, right? They are hearing very attentively. And then when suddenly philosophy starts coming up, a lot of philosophy in the lecture, then people go to Shavasana. And that's an art which we learn in Bhagavatam class, how can sleep while sitting. No, I never heard before someone sleeping while sitting in a Padmasana. You can sit like this and sleep, but not having any rest and yet sleeping. So that art, I think soon ISKCON we came and learned that art. So Shavasana, and then what happens if there is too much philosophy? The whole lecture is full philosophy only. Then someone feels after the lecture that he has done Sirsasana. Sir, bhari ho gaya. So anyways, we should express our eagerness for hearing. When there is eagerness for hearing, then there is a reciprocal relationship. And the Bhagavatam is offered very beautifully, gracefully. It enters into our karna randrena and also in our hearts. While hearing Bhagavatam, while we show attentiveness, we should also have faith in what we are hearing, right? Harikatha is certainly best, but we should have faith that whatever is in Bhagavatam is truth. It is not, okay, this is good, I accept it, but this is, I'll accept it later, let me check it out. So that means little Shraddha is not there. So this is the third point, we need to have faith in Bhagavatam. Then, the part of developing taste for hearing is also not that you just grab whatever you get from Bhagavatam, but you also have to share Bhagavatam. You see, many times when we hear something and we share with others, that point remains in our memory for a long time. But we just hear and then we don't share, the Bhagavatam is gone away, wiped away. Why? Because our Kali Yuga memory is very short-lived. So there's a need to give it to others, and there is a need also to be grateful that I am not qualified, but yet I have got this opportunity to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. There is no chance for me. I had no desire to hear Bhagavatam. But yet I am here in this temple hall and I am hearing Bhagavatam. I have access to Srimad Bhagavatam books of Srila Prabhupada. And then ultimately we should express our gratitude by always being eager to hear more and more and keep coming again. So this is what we learn from the sages of Naimisharanya, how we can develop taste for Srimad Bhagavatam. So Srimad Bhagavatam is nectar, Krishna consciousness topics are nectar. And the best part is, Lord Krishna, he arranges this nectar to keep reappearing in a way that we can keep relishing. That is also ecstatic, that is also dynamic. It is not like some book was written, that's it. Refer the book. No. Lord comes again and gives us more and more expansions of those books. I was just thinking that nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam is available for eternality. What is so special in Kali Yuga now? The special is 500 years ago, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared and he broke open the floodgate of that nectar and gave it to everyone to relish. Now he was distributing very openly. Take whoever wants. But he also wanted to be very organized. So he told the six Goswamis, now you distribute this nectar in an organized way. The six Goswamis went and stayed in Vrindavan, and in an organized way, they wrote all the books. Some of the later Goswamis were thinking that all the books have come, all the nectar has come, It's all organized, but yet it is limited. How it is limited? Most of the books are in Sanskrit language. So the later Goswamis, the later Acharyas thought, let us write in local language. So Gaudiya Vaishnavism was more in Bengal. So now Bengali literature started coming up. The same rasa was now distributed in Bengali language, Bengali rasa. Sanskrit rasa is not very easy. Not everyone understands Sanskrit. Now Bengali rasa. See our Acharyas, they come down the line. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami gave us rasa in Bengali language. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami is known as a very great Sanskrit scholar. It is said by our Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas that he gave three nectars, nectar pots, Amrita, Govinda Lila Amrita, then he wrote a commentary on Krishna Karna Amrita, and then he wrote Chaitanya Charita Amrita. So they said three nectars he gave us. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami. So Govinda Lila Amrit, Krishna Karna Amrit, Sanskrit language. Then why he, when he is a Kaviraj, he is expert poet in Sanskrit and he can compile and is in Radhakund, where most of the Goswamis are writing in Sanskrit language. Why did he think of writing in Bengali language? Because he saw most of the devotees will not understand Sanskrit. This nectar is great, but should be available to everyone. That's Mahaprabhu's mood. So many devotees would come and say, oh, Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami, please speak Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's nectar, the later pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami is thinking, if I write a book, these devotees may not know what I have written. They will require a translator. So in spite of his expertise in Sanskrit, he decided to go towards Bengali and write in Bengali language. She wrote Chaitanya Charitamrita in Bengali language and it became so popular, it became the main book of his life, Chaitanya Charitamrita. So this is how our Acharyas, they also make that nectar easily available. After Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami, we find later our Acharyas, they wrote Sanskrit also and Bengali also. Comes Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he decides, why only in Indian subcontinent Sanskrit and Bengali, local language, let's write in English language. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur now decides to write books in English language, Krishna conscious books. More than 100 books he wrote. Kept writing. He didn't thought, how I'll distribute this nectar? No problem. Let's create nectar. Distribution baad mein dekhenge. So he wrote so many books in English. His son, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, decided to print literatures in Bengali as well as English language. And his idea was this should be printed in a big way in English language for whole world to access. And then our Srila Prabhupada came and he wrote all the literatures in English language, but in an easy English language. When Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur wrote and Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote, they wrote more in a British English language. But here Srila Prabhupada, he wrote everything in English language, then he went all over the world and he became a salesman and distributing the nectar. So this is called as the greatness of our sampradaya, where this nectar has become so easily available for everyone to relish. So we have so far learned the steps of how to develop taste for hearing, relish. And we also seen the nectar is very easily available in all languages. Srila Prabhupada's great effort, now it is available in all languages, not just in English. Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada. Right? Russian language, even small languages, right? I was somewhere in Africa and I don't remember the language also. They printed a Bhagavad Gita in that language. So wondering, this is Prabhupada's mercy. That English language is there, but this should be also available. So inspired a devotee to write in a local language, local dialect, and present Bhagavad Gita in that language. One of the best things in our temple is that we have this Bhagavad Gita here in all languages. Right, I was referring that video where our Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited Delhi temple to inaugurate the biggest Bhagavad Gita in the whole world. And Gopal Krishna Maharaj was giving him a tour of the Bhagavad Gita. He opened the Bhagavad Gita, inaugurated. And Gopal Krishna Maharaj then took him to a library place. What was that? Bhagavad Gita in all languages. And he was very happy because he wanted this to happen, you know. Everyone becomes happy. Bhagavad Gita is not just in Hindi or Marathi or English language, but all languages all over the world. So this is what we can see, that the nectar is very easily accessible. Now our time, our opportunity is to access and actually relish that nectar. The problem is that nectar is there, no doubt about it. But somehow or other, I am not on that stage to access or rather drink the nectar. That swadu, swadu, pare, pare is not there. So what to do now, right? Bhagavatam is in our house. Bhagavatam lectures, so many things are on YouTube now, right? So many links are coming in Triloke Bhav mein, right? And we are thinking, which to hear, what to hear, where to hear, right? There's so much now. Online devotees are mentioning that previously we should come for a physical Bhagavatam class once in a day, right? Now online has become so prominent that you don't know what to hear and what not to hear. Time is not there. So we have enough quantity, right? But there is no taste. So what to do now, the taste? So nectar of instruction, Srila Rupa Goswami gives us. All our acharyas know what our condition life is, what is our disease. They already given solution before we even think. The solution is simple. In the nectar of instruction, Srila Rupa Goswami says, right now we are in disease state of mind. Prabhupada says in that purport that this Bhagavatam or this Krishna conscious nectar is like sugar candy. Now sugar candy is very difficult, right, to understand also, because in our Mumbai city we very rarely eat sugar candy. One time I was giving a class somewhere, I said, do you know sugar candy? I said, oh, kya hota hai Prabhuji, sugar candy. Candy malum hai, ice cream hoga kuch toh. See, sugar candy is, no, what do you say, mishri. It's a mishri. Anyway, people don't have so much taste for mishri also nowadays. Sugar cane juice, some taste is there. But anyways, the point is, mango juice, immediately taste is there. Everyone knows mango juice. Now season is coming slowly, slowly. So, in disease state of life, we cannot taste any food, right? Someday or in our life, we had some disease. And our family members cooked nice prasadam and somehow we could not eat it, right? Tasty nahi hai. Kyu? Sharir bimar hai. So when the body is diseased, we cannot taste even palatable foodstuffs. So the problem is in the foodstuff or us? Us, definitely. So what to do? We need to take medicines. In this case, Prabhupada says that we have bhava rog compared to jaundice. One who has jaundice, his whole tongue becomes bitter. So when tongue becomes bitter, what happens is that fellow cannot taste anything sweet. You give him sugar cane juice, he will drink one gulp and then he will say, enough, this is too bitter. Shakkar dal ke leke aao isme. But sugar cane juice itself is shakkar only. Why would you put extra shakkar in that? But this fellow is not able to taste because the tongue is bitter. So then what is told? You drink this, it is very sweet. Well, it is not sweet, I will not drink. Okay, drink it as medicine. No one drinks sugarcane juice as medicine, right? But when you are diseased, the same sugarcane juice becomes medicine. And then what? Slowly, gradually, keep drinking. After a few days, that same sugarcane juice, which is so bitter, becomes less bitter, lesser bitter. And finally, you get taste now. And you ask, why only one glass? Why not pade pade, swadu swadu, right? More glasses. Why only one glass? So Nectar of Instruction mentions this beautiful verse. It says, rasanasya na rochikanu. There is ras, but there is no rochik. There is no taste. So what to do? Kintu adarad anudinam khalu saiva justam. Rupa Goswami, he says, yes, I appreciate, I accept that there is no taste in chanting, there is no taste in Krishna consciousness which we have now. But there is a process. Na rochikanu, but kintu adarad. Adarad means respectfully or carefully. Adar, adar se. Anudinam, regularly. खलु सैव जुष्टम टेक, जुष्टम मीन्स टू टेक, एंड एव सर्टनली नेचुरली द टेस्ट विल कम. जस्ट लाइक यू कीप ड्रिंकिंग द शुगर केन जूस, इवन दो इट्स बिटर, इवेंचुअली द शुगर केन जूस विल टेस्ट स्वीटर. स्वाद्वी क्रमात, स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे, स्वाद्वी क्रमात, द स्वाद विल कम इवेंचुअली ऑर्गेनिकली. सो वॉट इज द सोल्यूशन? इफ आई डोंट हैव टेस्ट फॉर चैंटिंग, इफ आई डोंट हैव टेस्ट फॉर भागवतम, वॉट टू डू? टेक इट एज मेडिसिन. फॉर अस भागवतम इज मेडिसिन, फॉर अस चैंटिंग इज मेडिसिन. फॉर रूप गोस्वामी भागवतम वॉज नेक्टर, चैंटिंग वॉज नेक्टर, राइट? Therefore, you find in many bhajans, in many literatures, sometimes chanting is called as medicine, sometimes chanting is called as nectar. Right? Jeeva jago, Gaura Chandra bole. In that bhajan, yenechi aushadi maya nashi varo lage. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, yenechi aushadi maya. Aushadi means medicine. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come with his medicine. So medicine is for those who are not able to relish. But the same thing is relishable for very those devotees who have higher taste. Now for us to chant 16 rounds is like, you know, big tapasya every day, day after day. Many devotees, they feel very happy when they chanted, right? And they 16 rounds, aaj japa khatam ho gaya. Very nice word, khatam. I have finished my chanting, not completed. Completed is a good word, but finished. Somehow we are very happy, we feel very relieved, some big burden is there, you know. The whole day, if chanting remains for the whole day you are just thinking, you know, when I will go home and chant. Bara mala bacha hai, aaj bara bajne wala hai. So it's a big headache. And again next day, same chanting. So this is called as medicine, just take it. Rupa Goswami on the other hand, when he was chanting, he was relishing. And he was praying, why just one tongue, Krishna? You are giving your holy name, you are giving the nectar of Krishna consciousness, and you have given just one tongue to chant. I want millions of tongues to chant and millions of ears to hear. Now we never ever say that prayer, millions of tongues to chant and millions of ears to hear. Why? Because that taste has not come. So Rupa Goswami is showing us that platform at which the taste will come. But till that time, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavati Ruttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Regular attendance in Srimad Bhagavatam class, Srila Prabhupada writes in the translation. Regular attendance, whether you like it or don't like it, just come and sit. Regular attendance. Sometimes in college we have to go for attendance, right? We may not like the class. Lekin attendance nahi milega to pass nahi hoga. So even if that thing is there, okay, no problem, come and sit, attend, hear, something will go inside, something will stick. However, one very important thing is, devotees should not jump to that level when the taste is not there. That's very nice, important thing to know, that sometimes people, they imitate that taste, even though the taste is not there. Our literatures like Srimad Bhagavatam, they are not spoken, they are revealed. They are revealed literatures. They are not written, they are not heard, they are not whatever in a book form. It has been revealed. So even though it is there in front of us, ultimately it will be revealed. Therefore we call it as open secret. It is there with us. Hamare ghar mein hai, lekin secret hai, open hai. Like having a mobile phone, right? If I give my mobile phone to all of you, you may say thank you, but if that mobile has a passcode, what is the use of my mobile? It is there, but it's of no use to all of us. So Bhagavatam is there, everything is there, but it's all passcoded. There is a secret you to enter inside. So we hear from our parampara, Brahma got this Srimad Bhagavatam. It is not mentioned that he heard it. He was revealed to his heart. Tene Brahma Hridaya Adi Kavaye. Vyasadeva also, this revelation came to his heart. So this literature cannot be like, you know, imitated and scholarly attempt made and get taste for it, no. Today morning we sang Guru Puja, you know. Divya Gyan Pustake Prakashito, Hriday Prakashito. So while we have Pustak, but ultimately it is our sincerity when it counts, when you do the step-by-step approach, then Krishna will reveal us those literature. Srila Prabhupada will reveal us those literature. That is how we should do. Therefore, very important to know that we should go step by step. There are many people who have left ISKCON who said that Srila Prabhupada has not given everything. Let us go to some other people and they have given more higher knowledge, rasa, higher rasas. Prabhupada gave only basic rasa because he had very less time. It is not like that. Prabhupada had a lot of time. But Prabhupada knew what is our stage, right? So he gave rasa as per our stage, because that is very easy to give. The later rasas does not have to be given. It will be organically coming in our life. So, like one devotee was mentioning beautifully in his class, that there is sadhana bhakti, right? We are doing sadhana bhakti of chanting, hearing regularly. People want to go to higher rasas. Raga bhakti, bhava bhakti, prema bhakti. But this bhakti will not come just by reading shastra. This will come by following raga, vaidhi bhakti, sadhana bhakti very meticulously. So when you follow vaidhi bhakti properly, then automatically we come to the stage of raga bhakti and spontaneous attraction and relishing of this stages here. So we cannot jump on the higher stages. We have to relish gradually as we go into our Krishna consciousness deep and deeper, and we practice our Krishna consciousness strongly day by day, swadvi kramad, the taste will come. Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami mentions a very beautiful point, that we need help. When we take medicines, we can't take medicines by our own. We need help of a superior person or a doctor. And that doctor is compared to a devotee. So while you're practicing Krishna consciousness and everyday chanting, everyday reading books and everyday following principles, it is not like first 2 years we need someone who can guide us. After that, now I know everything. Why do I need people? Why do I need devotees? I'll be freelancing, right? Sometimes whenever required, I will access. No, we need always devotees. When we are new devotees, we need association of great devotees. When we are great devotees, we will also need association of great devotees as well. If someone says that I am a great devotee, I don't require great other association of, he is not a great devotee. He is just imitating devotee. We need devotees association at every stage who help us to grow in our Krishna consciousness. So I want to remind you all again that we are discussing about what? Nectar. Swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade. And we went through this whole class understanding that swadhu, swadhu, pade, pade has been a very important word which has been rhyming or ringing in our ears. And we also want to get taste. And the taste is available through what Srila Suta Goswami and Shaunaka Adi Rishi are showing us. And how to develop the taste in disease state, that's what Nectar of Instruction says, that we should regularly keep doing what we are doing and eventually the taste will come. Now I will take you to a life story of a very nice devotee who did not have a taste, but he developed a taste. And ultimately their swadhu swadhu pade pade reached its climax. So we have some more time, we can recite this beautiful story. I'll take you to Maharashtra. We are already in Maharashtra, but in Maharashtra I'll take you to Pandharpur. So in Pandharpur, Lord Vitthal is standing there beautifully with hands on his hips. Now, near Pandharpur, just close by Pandharpur, 25 kilometers away, there is a village called as Mangal Veda. In Mangal Veda, there was one very simple person. He came from very, very low class. His name was Chokha Mela. Very famous name in Maharashtra, Sant Chokha Mela. Chokha Mela was born in a Mahar family, and that time there was very strong system in India where caste system was blown off out of place, and people were ridiculed because of their birth. And it is not just in India, it happened last few years back, but it happened all over the world. Everywhere down the world, people become very proud of their birth, their lineage, whether it's in Christianity or Judaism or in Islam or in Hinduism. Wherever you see, people become proud of their birth, their religion, then they become oppressive, right? It's not a new thing. People sometimes say, in India, I became backward because of this reason. Everywhere it's happening, not just in India. But that time in India was very prevalent. It became, instead of the spirit of the law, the letter of the law became very prominent. And people were like, you know, outcasted, you know. You just cannot come into a temple, you cannot go a particular area. So being of that caste, Chokhamela had limitations to practice religiosity and spiritual life. But he was very sincere. So he came to Pandharpur, and from very far away, he would see the temple, take darshan of temple, Gopuram, the dome, and be satisfied. But he did come. He did not thought that I am not getting darshan, so why should I go to Pandharpur? He came regularly. That was his sincerity. He did not know what is what, but he thought, let me keep going because this is something very important. That's called as sadhana bhakti. Do your things, whether you know it or don't know it, it is told we should do it. Everyone goes to Pandharpur, I should also go, whether I get darshan or not, I'll go. That was his sincerity. So Chokhamela and his wife Soharabai, they would come regularly to Pandharpur and they would not get darshan and go back. Can you imagine coming to a holy place and knowing that you'll not get darshan, but still coming? That's called sincerity. And because he was sincere, Lord Vitthal was watching all that. Lord Vitthal arranged for him to get proper guidance. So one time, Sant Namdev Maharaj, who is also a very great devotee, he came to Pandharpur. And when he was staying in Pandharpur, he was glorifying the Lord, Lord's holy name, Lord's glory in the public, and people would come and dance in the Sankirtan there. So Chokhamela also got a chance to hear from Namdev Maharaj. And he would regularly go to that place where every day Namdev Maharaj would chant. And there was a huge crowd of devotees, they would hear from Namdev Maharaj. So Chokhamela would stand very far away, thinking that I am very low class, I should not go close to him. But Namdev Maharaj saw one thing, that everyone, every day people are coming, people are changing, but this person is not changing. Kintu adarad anudinam khalu saiva justam. Respectfully and anudinam, day after day, he showed his sincerity. Then Namdev Maharaj went to him and said, I am seeing you every day coming, but you did not come to meet me. He said, I am coming from a very low birth. How can I come to meet you? He said, for devotion, there is no requirement of birth. For practicing Krishna consciousness, all you require is devotion, not high birth. And then Namdev Maharaj said, I saw you very sincere. So today I will initiate you in Krishna consciousness. He gave him initiation and told him, you take the names of Vitthal every day without fail. As much as possible till you reach the gamut where you chant regularly. Pare pare. The same thing what we are discussing. So Chokhamela, he was very grateful, as Shaunakadi Rishis are teaching us, you know. We should be grateful for the opportunity we have got. He was very grateful and now he began to practice chanting. So he decided to stay in Pandharpur for a long time. So while he was in Pandharpur, he did not get a chance to go inside. So he was sweeping the streets around temple premises every day without fail, and he would sing Lord Vitthal's song. And eventually he got some taste where he composed Abhangas by himself. He was not educated, but just by chanting regularly Vitthal's name, he was empowered. Mukham Garoti Vachalam Pangu Langayate Grim. And he started composing Abhangas. And he would sing those Abhangas. He never wrote those Abhangas to be published later. He just sang the Abhangas. And he was every day sweeping. One day some people were very jealous and envious. Well, it's fine. Should not think ISKCON is like that now only. It is always like that. People always there who are very less intelligent, who always are very envious of others' progress. That is always there in every society of Krishna consciousness, whether it's now ISKCON or some other mutt, always been like that, right? Like our Vrajbihari Pu was mentioning a beautiful story this time, Nityananda Desi. Someone asked one book distributor when he was distributing books. Now you are glorifying Bhagavad Gita while distributing Bhagavad Gita Liji, Eki Ji, Hare Krishna Mandir Ki Taraf Se. This is from the Hare Krishna Temple. Yeah, you are Hare Krishna Temple, huh? We have come there. Can you tell me one fault of Hare Krishna Temple? You are glorifying so much Hare Krishna Temple. So the point was, maybe if that devotee does not speak, then he will start speaking about the faults. So the devotee was thinking, now what should I say, you know? But he was like in a whole train, the whole conversation was going on. So the devotee immediately replied, yes, there is one big fault of ISKCON. One biggest fault of ISKCON is our doors are open. Anyone can come and practice Krishna consciousness. हमने एंट्री पे लगाया नहीं है कि आप गुजराती है, मारवाड़ी है, मराठी है, कौन से कास्ट से है, मीडियम आप मिडिल क्लास है, हाई क्लास है, राइट? देयर इज नो पैरामीटर. एनीवन कैन कम एंड टेक पार्ट एंड बिकम अ डिवोटी एंड प्रैक्टिस कृष्णा कॉन्शियस, बिकम मेंबर ऑफ इस्कॉन, राइट? फर्स्ट डे व्हेन यू केम, आई रिमेंबर फर्स्ट डे व्हेन आई केम, एवरीवन टोल्ड मी प्रभुजी. आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज प्रभुजी, बट आई बिकेम प्रभुजी ऑन द फर्स्ट डे. टाइटल्ड that title which is for everyone became, I became entitled on the first day, right on the first day when I came, Prabhuji. So that is the greatness of any society. It gives chance to everyone. So you'll find always mix of people here. So we should not be very much concerned or get we must overly concerned about if someone is blaspheming other, you know, some devotees there who's not on that level, he starts blaspheming other devotees. Theek hai, koi baat nahi. सबका साथ सबका विकास. वी ऑल आर टुगेदर, ईच अदर हेल्प ईच अदर. लाइक सो इन दैट होल पंडरपुर एरिया देर आर सम पीपल हु आर लिविंग इन पंडरपुर धाम वासिस, बट देर थिंकिंग ना दिस गाय इज सिंगिंग नाइस अवंगास, वेरी ब्लिसफुल, हैप्पी, नो प्रॉब्लम. सो दे वेंट एंड वन डे टॉन्टेड हिम एंड यू आर ब्रूमिंग एवरी डे, व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग? सेड आई एम गेटिंग कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस. व्हाट इज यूज ऑफ कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस? यू आर ब्रूमिंग, यू विल नॉट गेट दर्शन, देन व्हाई यू आर ब्रूमिंग? You want to show off that you are a good devotee. Now that Chokhamila did not ever think about that in his mind, ever. But now someone showed him that, you know, that you are booming because you want to show off. So he went back home and he was lamenting that I never thought like that, but people are thinking about me like that. That means it must be there in my heart. I want to show off. So he said, I will fast. I will not eat anything. And I will not do anything. I will not go to temple again. So Lord Vitthal was thinking, I am missing Chokhamila, you know, he didn't come yesterday, he went halfway through, today morning also he did not come, and he's fasting also. So Lord Vitthal went from his temple to his house and met him, and he was surprised. Chokhamila had not seen Lord Vitthal, he had seen Vitthal from very far distance from a small window. That was the only darshan and maybe some photographs, I don't know, photographs were not at that time, but paintings, right? Here Vitthal came to the house of Chokhamila and began talking to him, gave him Mahaprasad. And he said, you don't come, but I will come every day to meet you. So this was the greatness of Chokhamila, that by his regular practice of Krishna consciousness, now Lord Vitthal was coming to meet him. Now one day Lord Vitthal said, you have never come inside temple, I will take you today. He said, no, I am not qualified. No. This is my temple, I'll qualify you. Why you have to read qualification of others, you know? So he took him to temple inside. And everyone was watching Chokhamila walking, but they were not watching Vitthal is taking him by hand. So everyone was surprised. So finally he entered into the altar area. And there was a priest there and he was alarmed. He became unhappy. Chokhamila, how can you enter this place? You made the whole altar impure. He said, I did not enter. Vitthal brought me here. He said, Vitthal brought you here. Again, you're lying now. So he became so angry. Then he went and complained to the head priest. And he said that generally they are not allowed to come inside. And now he directly barge inside the temple. So temple has to be cleaned now. The altar has to be thoroughly washed. And you should punish him something. So that he does not do again. So everyone comes together and they punish. What is the punishment? You can't stay in Pandharpur here. He said, well, I have to stay in Pandharpur. I like this place. Okay, you stay beyond Chandrabhaga on the other side. So he was staying very close to temple, but now his location shifted to the other side of Chandrabhaga on the other banks. So very far away. That time there was no bridge, you know. You have to take a boat and come to this side. So now the frequency came down of coming and he was very unhappy. But Lord Vitthal did not stop coming.
Lord Vittal would every day during come during lunchtime and he would say, I'm coming and I'll take prasad in your house. And Soyera Bai would cook. And whatever little was there, she would serve to Chokha Mela and also Vittal. And this happened every day. So he did not require to go to temple, right? Because Lord himself is coming to his house. One fine day, that very priest was very anti against Chokha Mela, happened to come on the other banks of Chandrabhaga, and he was walking by. And that time, lunchtime, Vittal was in the house, and Chokha Mela and Vittal were eating prasadam, and Soyera Bai was serving. And by mistake, Soyera Bai was serving curd, so it just spilled off, and it fell on the shawl of Krishna, Pitambar shawl of Krishna. So immediately Chokha Mela said, hey, what you did? You spoiled the cloth of Vittal. You put dahi on Vittal's cloth. Now that time this guy was walking, this pujari, he heard that and he thought that just to pull my leg, this Chokha Mela is trying to tease me by saying that Vittal has come to my house and Vittal has, we put curd in the shawl of Vittal. So he became so unhappy, he came inside. And this is what happens. He went and directly, he slapped Chokha Mela. And Chokha Mela was thinking, what happened suddenly, you know? We are having prasadam. This person was not able to see Vittal is there sitting. He could only see Soyera Bai and Chokha Mela, could not see Vittal. And he said, you tease me and this is the punishment you get. And then by that time, then he left that place. He took a boat. This pujari came on the other side and directly went to the altar. When he went to the altar, he saw something unnatural. The right cheek of Vittal was swollen. It became red. You think, how this has happened? So Lord Vittal spoke to him, you rascal, you know what you have done? Today you slapped one of my very great devotees. So that slap, I took it on my face. And this is because you slapped me, the cheeks have swollen. And this will remain swollen till you go and don't ask for forgiveness. Then the priest realized that actually Lord Vittal was every day going and he would go and give association to Chokha Mela in his house. So the priest hurriedly went to the other side, he offered obeisances, begged forgiveness, and Chokha Mela was also very, not very happy. He was thinking, why are you offering obeisances? You are the pujari of the Lord. Said, you have to come now, temple, because without you, Lord will not be happy. So he literally pulled him, brought him to temple hall. And then Lord saw Vittal, immediately the swollen cheek became normal. In this, Chokha Mela now slowly gained popularity as a very great devotee. People appreciated him. He was allowed to come in a temple. But for him, all that fame did not work much. He was more now into relishing, hearing and chanting at every moment. After some day, what happened? People in Mangalveda, they were forced to do an activity of constructing a big wall. The people who were very of high class in Mangalveda decided that there has to be a segregation of those who are low class and those who are high class. Let's build a big, gigantic stone wall. So all people who are construction people, they should all come and take part in this. So one of the construction members was Chokha Mela. So he was forcefully brought to Mangalveda. And they were building this huge wall. It was out of context. I mean, the wall was too huge. This was the level at which people were so proud of their birth. They decided to make a wall that the shadow of the person should also not come here. So huge the wall was. And unfortunately, while making that wall, stone wall, the wall collapsed. And everyone working on that site, the wall collapsed on those people and they all died, including Chokha Mela. He also left his body. And people who are very rich, people who are very high birth, they said, oh, anyways, they're going to die and they're going to buried and anyways, well buried, don't touch anything. The stone has buried the dead people. They did not touch, they did not allow anyone to even check for the bodies because the bodies were highly dismantled because of the weight of the huge stones. Namdev came to know about all this. He was very disturbed that a great devotee like Chokha Mela has lost his life. So he came all the way from Pandarpur to Mangalveda. It took time for him to come. When he came there, he was not allowed to go inside that place where this whole thing happened. After some time, he somehow managed. By the time, because the body is there for a long time, what happens? Then it gets decomposed and all those things. So all those bodies were inside decomposed and only bones were there. Chokhamela went and he wanted to make a samadhi of Chokhamela. Namdev Maharaj went and wanted to make Chokhamela samadhi. He wanted to know now which bones are Chokhamela's bones. But he knew very well, this person was very Krishna conscious. Sadhu, sadhu, pade, pade. So he went and he saw that those bones, he picked up all the bones. And there are some bones which were chanting Vitthal's name. From the bones, there was vibration of Vitthal's name. And he understood this was the bone of Chokhamela. He collected all those bones, which were chanting the holy names of Vitthal, got those bones. And in front of Lord Vitthal's temple in Pandarpur, just the place where Chokhamela would every day stand and sing Abhangas, that very place, he made a samadhi. Even today, if you go to Pandarpur, on the front side of the temple, there is Namdev Pairi, where this great devotee Namdev also entered into samadhi. Just front of Namdev is Chokhamela samadhi. So here is some person who was a very religious person, a very spiritual minded person, interested in spiritual life. Just in one lifetime, because of the guidance of great devotees, a stage had come in his life where, what to speak of chanting, relishing chanting, his existence was full of chanting, even his bones chanted the holy names. So this is the stage of Krishna consciousness which we are talking here, where Suta Goswamis, where Savarnakadi Rishis are relishing swadhu swadhu pade pade. And we are mentioning about how we can come to that stage by, under guidance of devotees, regularly do what they tell us to do. And eventually that stage will come by our sincerity and we will relish swadhu swadhu pade pade. There is one more example of one such devotee more, who by chanting actually created a transformation even in non-moving objects. So Namdev Maharaj, he had many disciples. One disciple was Chokhamela, one more disciple was Janabai. So Janabai was always like a servant in the house of Namdev Maharaj, serving very nicely the whole family. So Janabai, her service every day was to make, to do whatever necessary, but one of the main services was to make cow dung paddies, right? Yeah, gobar, kande. So she would do every day. And because there was a limited place, she made a lot of gobar kande, and then there was a neighboring lady also, she also would make gobar kande. And then one day there was a tussle between two ladies, which gobar kanda is mine and which is yours, right? And that was the time, it is said in the literatures of Maharashtra saints of Maharashtra, that Kabir, Saint Kabir, well-known Kabir, he had heard about the great devotion of Namdev and also Janabai. So he wanted to know, who is this lady? That our devotion has become famous all over India. Namdev Maharaj, Abhangas were also famous in Punjab also. There are some places in Punjab, in the literatures of the Sikh tradition, they have names of Namdev Maharaj, right, Prabhu? Bhachandrapu is agreeing with that. So Namdev Maharaj was well known, but Janabai also became well known. So Kabir, he came all the way from Punjab to check who is this Janabai, Mataji devotee who is famous. So he was told she is arranging cow dung there, you know. So when he came, that was the time when Janabai was fighting with the other lady. About what? Cow dung. This is my cow dung. That is, you know, surprise. She is a great devotee, but now she is fighting for what? Cow dung, you know. He could not reconcile the whole thing. He kya ho raha hai? I came to meet a great devotee. I thought she will be chanting Hare Krishna constantly. She will be ecstasy. But here is a devotee who is fighting for what? Gobar. So Namdev Maharaj came that time. He understood this dilemma in Kabir's mind. And he said, Janabai, what happened? He said, oh, this kande is for Vitthal and she's taking it. She will use for sense gratification. This is our kanda. This is our gobar. So Namdev Maharaj said, there is one way we can check. Whose gobar is it? It is Janabai's or it is the other lady's? What is the test? He told Kabir, you know, you can go and hear. Put your ear on every kanda. He said, "Kya, what will I hear? You go and hear." So he went and heard one kande, one that Gobarkanda, Vitthal, Vitthal, Vitthal name was coming. So Janabai was so powerful lady, she was relishing Krishna consciousness, that went, vibrations entered into that Gobarkanda also. And in this way, Kabir was able to kind of divide the whole Kandas just by hearing those Gobarkandas, the names of Lord Vitthal. So here are great devotees we are hearing, Suta Goswami, Shaunakadi Rishi, Parikshit Maharaj, 7 days continuously hearing. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exemplifying this whole thing of continuously hearing. Then the question is, how we will get that taste? And it's a simple process. Whatever we are doing, continue to do it. Right? There is no new formula which is going to come in new Bhagavatam class. Sometimes we will ask, naya formula kuch aayega. Whatever we are doing, we should continue doing it more sincerely and more better way in the association and under the guidance of devotees. And eventually, we'll come to that stage. Now, we have heard about Chukamela's progress from a simple religious person to a very highly elevated Vaishnava. So, I spoke this story in 15 minutes, right? In 15 minutes, the whole life story was spoken. So, it takes time for everyone to come to that stage. But there is always a hope. Srila Prabhupada has given us hope that if you chant our rounds regularly, if you chant, if you come in association of devotees, follow four principles regularly, then what will happen? One day we'll achieve perfection of life. That's possible in this very life. If we continue the process of Krishna consciousness very sincerely and very seriously, it's possible. All conditions are favorable. Now we have to continue the process day in and day out. Kintu adarad anudinam. And then justa. Then what will happen? That day will come when swadvi kramad will develop taste for our Krishna consciousness. And we would not just say swadhu swadhu pade pade, but we will experience swadhu swadhu pade pade. Hare Krishna. We are already short of time, but I can take one question or one comment if some devotee has got. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai Srila Prabhupada.